Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Gaia Q, and I was working with someone recently on a composite model. There were ags and direct query tables and dual tables and import tables, and we noticed something kind of strange. And I said, we gotta fix this before we publish this out and people start using it because it could affect performance. So how do we fix it? Well, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So we started here. We had a direct query table, my fact table, and we had the ag table that was mapped to that fact table and some dimension tables. This particular dimension was gonna be used for aggregations, and that was one of the primary reasons we brought in the ag table. So we established a relationship between that table and the ag table, but we also had to establish a relationship between the fact table where all the mappings happen to that dimension also. And we noticed this limited relationship. It's like, why is that there? You only see limited relationships when there's a many-to-many relationship or the tables are from two different sources. And I was like, we gotta fix this. And I know how to fix this. Essentially, we have two sources here. And so that's why we see that limited relationship. This is gonna come from the memory analysis services, and this comes from SQL Server. So I said, we just need to switch this table to dual mode. And so I've kind of prepped this up like a cooking show a little bit. See right here, I have this table in dual mode. I'm gonna go ahead and enable the load. Bring it in, and I said, all right, let's get rid of this relationship. Delete, delete, and move this table away. And we're gonna use this one, but we'll switch it to dual mode first. And now we'll just establish our relationships. We'll put one over here, right? Good solid relationship, right? A regular relationship. And then we'll put one here and still a limited relationship. Now, some people already may notice what's causing the problem. In the data model view, when your tables come from two different sources, if it's a different color, it's two different sources. So I'm like, wait a minute, same server, same database, same server, same database. But wait, take a look at that database name. The case of both of those don't match. That's why it's producing those different sources. I remember a long time ago when the gateway came out, this was a challenge. But for some relational databases, case sensitivity is really important and it's still persisted, you know, in this model view. And so we got to correct it. So what do? So he was ready to delete the table and add it back. But I was like, wait, I got an idea. Let me show you something. So went into transform data. Watch this. Really simple. Over here to this customer new, went to the source step, and we just matched the case A, and then I think it was DW over here, close and apply. Watch, it's gonna load that table up. It goes blue and boom, no more limited relationship. So you gotta be careful when you're specifying the database name because it needs to match when you're bringing in new tables if you're not using that existing source. Alberto and Marco has a great article that discusses limited or weak relationship in the docs. And I'll put a link to both of those in the description below. All right, if you wanna learn more about data modeling and more about relationships, you should go check out the playlist we have on data modeling. Any questions, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.